Boulevard, the bulk of the British force and part of the French 1st Army escaped through a narrow aisle into the pocket around Dunkirk.
To dream the impossible dream.
A defense perimeter is established.
To fight the unbeatable foe. To bear with unbearable sorrow. To run where the brave do not go. To right the unrightable wrong. To fight though unchased from afar. To try when your arms are too weary to reach the unreachable star. This is my quest, to follow that star. No matter how hopeless, no matter how far, to fight for the right without question or pause. To be willing to march into hell for a heavenly cause. And I know you could only be true to this glorious quest that my heart will light peacefully come. When I'm laying to my bed, and the world will be better for this.
German leading tanks within sight of Dunkirk.
That one man, tall and covered with stars, still strove with his last ounce of courage.
Operation Dynamo is underway, but from the beginning it seems doomed to failure. The first ship to survive the minefields, the torpedoes, and the Luftwaffe on the way across the channel now find themselves under the German guns at Calais.
And in those fields in ancient times, walk upon England's mountains green, and was the holy Lamb of God on England's pleasant pastures. And in the countenance divine, shine for the heart about it is, and was Jerusalem built here among these dark satanic hills.
Or
shall my sword sleep in my hand till we have been
the 30th, an urgent telephone call goes to the British War Ministry. Perimeter cannot be held for long. Send as many boats and as much ammunition as possible. By May 30th, all of the British Expeditionary Force and the remnants of the French First Army are now compressed into a corner of beach 24 miles long, 6 miles wide. From across the channel, the strangest fleet in the history begins the material. From the weekend news and the world need to the grimy working of the everything that can float is pressed into service.
How shall we extol?
Frenchmen, too, thronging the beaches, Churchill orders them given an equal opportunity for evacuation. By the 31st, 200,000 men have been lifted.
And going home on a minesweeper. We are shoved into every part of that boat except the bridge and the engine room. Every bit of space is used wherever you look. You see people.
Again, there'll be bluebirds over the white cliffs of Dover. Tomorrow, just you
wait and see. And in England, there will be fruit on the trees.
at 11:30 p.m., June 2nd, Dunkirk signals British Expeditionary Force evacuation.
The valley will bloom again, and Jimmy will go to sleep in his own little room again.
At 9 in the morning of June 3rd, Dunkirk
surrenders. The white cliffs of Dover tomorrow. Just you wait and see.